Infill patterns look really neat, right? But they always end up hidden under the top and bottom layers, or behind perimeters. But what if they didn't? In this video, we'll show you how to reveal parts of the infill and breathe new life into otherwise rather simple models, leveraging the power of modifier meshes in Prusa Slicer. If you were to set the number of perimeters to zero globally, your model would look pretty strange. You probably don't want to do that. So that's where the modifier meshes step in. They're one of the advanced tools in Prusa Slicer, and they've been there for a long time. But working with them in the previous versions was awkward and slow, so almost nobody used them. Well, now they're much easier to place exactly where you want them to be. So what do modifier meshes do? They let you set custom settings and apply them only where the modifier mesh intersects the model. So you can set denser infill, more perimeters, or slow down the print. You can use either simple shapes, generated directly in Prusa Slicer, or load a model that you created externally. Okay, let's take a look at some examples. If you try to slice and print this SpaceX coaster, it would probably end up looking like this. Not bad, but if you remove the top and bottom layers for the black part, you get this mesmerizing effect. Let's jump into Prusa Slicer and set it up for this print. After importing it, choose the triangles infill with 60% density. For the next part, make sure that you're in the advanced or expert mode. Right-click on the model and select Add Modifier Cylinder. Using the Scale tool, enlarge the cylinder and then move it so that it only covers the bottom part of the model without the SpaceX logo. Then right-click on the modifier mesh in the scene and choose Layers and Perimeters. New settings are now displayed in the lower right corner. Set both top and bottom layers to zero and check the preview. Don't forget to add the color changes, and you're ready to export the G-code. In the upcoming version 2.1, instead of using modifier meshes, you can make these changes based on the layer height. Right-click on the model and click Edit Layers. Then you can set the two heights, between which will the custom settings be applied. And from this point, it works exactly the same way as if it was a modifier mesh. And by the way, you can add multiple height intervals, and each can change completely different settings. In a similar way, using modifier meshes, we can modify this phone case. The trick here is that we first used a modifier mesh to turn the top and bottom layers off, and then we loaded a second one in the shape of a plane that turns them back on. And if you switch the printer to the MMU, you can even assign different extruder, well, color, to the affected area. So this is a really simple way to modify models for the MMU. And by the way, don't forget that there are different infill patterns for the top and bottom layers, so try and experiment with them. Removing perimeters works pretty much the same, but here you should really consider using 3D infills, like the gyroid or cubic infill. Creating this pencil holder took just a few minutes. It's literally just a cuboid, minus the volume for pencils. Then use a modifier mesh to set the number of perimeters to zero. If you don't turn off top layers, you'll end up with solid layers on top. But honestly, this looks pretty good, and creates a clean end for the infill, so let's leave it like this. Consider adding a second modifier mesh, just below the first one, and set the infill to 100% with rectilinear pattern. This way there will be a few solid layers before the new infill begins. And again, with the version 2.1, you can achieve the same effect with the Edit Layers function. Modifier meshes are an incredibly powerful tool, and you could also use them to improve mechanical properties of your prints or greatly reduce the print time. But let's leave that for another video. You'll find the links for the G-codes and Prusa Slicer project files in the video description. Consider subscribing if you enjoy these videos, and as always, happy printing!